1. This morning, we have a very special guest who's going to share with you a bit about a video with some of our own friends in it, as well as tell you a little bit why the message of that film is so important. She's been to PBS before. She's a good friend of our school. Please give a warm welcome to Professor Joe Boaler.
Good morning, everybody. So today I thought I would share with you, well, this is me, we're a little bit off the screen. My name is Joe. I'm from England, as you can see from that little flag. And that's why I say maths and not math, but we all won't talk about that. What I want to share with you is some things about the brain. So a lot of people in the United States think that you're either born with a maths brain or you're not. This is not the case. And nobody is born with a maths brain or without one. And I want to share with you how your mathematical brain develops. So this is kind of what our brains look like. It has these neurons floating around inside the brain. And when you learn something new, there's one of three things that happen. So this is one possibility. When you learn something new, I don't know if we'll see this well, a new brain pathway forms. Can you see that little dotted line? And the first time you learn it, it's really delicate little pathway in the brain. But the more you think about that idea, the deeper and stronger that pathway becomes, until it becomes a pathway that stays with you forever and that you use. So that's one thing that can happen. Another thing that can happen up here is a pathway you already have gets stronger. And the third possibility, which I think you can see down here, is that two pathways you have in your brain start to form a connection. Oh, you missed the connection. A connection that wasn't there before. So every time you learn some new maths or anything at all, Those are the three things that can happen. You strengthen a pathway, you form a new pathway, or you connect two pathways together. And that's how your maths brain develops. So don't never think that people are born with those brains or they're not. And to remind you of that, there was an amazing story of a six-year-old girl who had half of her brain taken out because she was having terrible things happen that doctors couldn't work out what to do. So they took out half her brain, and they thought that for years and years and years, she would not be able to run or do lots of things that the brain helps us with. But she amazed doctors, because within months of her operation, she'd grown all these new pathways and was running around again. So this was when doctors started to realize that our brains were amazingly plastic, and you can really learn anything at any time. The other thing that's important to know is what you believe about yourself changes what you learn. So I don't know if you've looked much at graphs yet, but this graph is kids' math scores going through middle school, and kids who don't believe that they can learn, this is them on the bottom. But kids who believe that they can learn anything, this is them going upwards and upwards all the time. So what you believe is very important. And turns out that one of the best things for your brain is when you make a mistake. When you make a mistake, your brain grows, that's right. It becomes, pathways grow and they get stronger. So that's a really important thing to remember. That's right. And struggle is really good. When you find something really hard, that's great, because that's your brain is on fire with growth. And you see this here, this is very interesting. These are brains in a study. And this brain over here is the brain of people when they made mistakes and when they believed in themselves. And then their brains were on fire with activity. And this brain, not so much on fire, because they didn't believe in themselves. So imagine that when you're working on maths and you struggle, this is what's going on in your brain. It's like pew, on fire with growth. if you believe in yourself and if you believe I can learn anything. So it's very important to have that belief. Other things that are important to know, maths is not about speed. And the best maths thinkers, the mathematicians out there in the world, think really slowly and deeply. So don't think you have to be quick with numbers to be good at maths. That's really not the case. So some advice for you as you learn maths. Do it with your friends. It's really good to be social with maths and to talk with other people about things. It's always good to think visually. Our brains want to think in pictures and with visuals with maths. And always think about the meaning of things. Why does that work? What's going on? And then believe in yourself. So the last thing I want to share with you is we made a website. You can find the website later. It's called Youcubed. And we're trying to change maths in this country. I'm going to show you a little video which kind of is an example of why we want to change maths in this country. This is a video that a high school student made and put onto YouTube. And they made this video because their maths class was so boring. And let's just watch. This high schooler said, this is me during my maths class. So this is what we're trying to change. We'll watch this little video.
Since our first equation tells us that y equals 3x plus 2, this means that we can substitute a 3x plus 2 in for the y in our second equation. In other words, since y means the same thing as 3x plus 2, we can replace the y in the second equation with a 3x plus 2. And rewriting our second equation, we now have 7x minus 4 times parentheses 3x plus 2.
Falling asleep is a maths teacher talking on and on and on. But that's on YouTube too. We're trying to change that and make maths class much more exciting. But here in this school, I know you have some amazing teachers. And one of the things we just made was a film that we've put out to the world, and over 50,000 people have already looked at it, that includes 4 of your students. And we made the film because a lot of people in the US have these beliefs that you're smart or you're not, that you're gifted or you're not. These are wrong ideas, and we really want to change that. And I think you're going to see later the full film with your teachers, which includes some of my Stanford undergrads talking about how lots of people told them they were smart and special, and that actually held them back and stopped them wanting to try on things. So in our film, we hear from Stanford undergrads, and then 4 of your amazing colleagues came in to talk about the ideas they've got in this school, which are very important ideas about that everybody can learn. And so we're very grateful to the 4 people who came into the film. We've had amazing reactions from adults all over the world, loving what the 4 of you, wherever you are. Maybe you could stand up, the 4 of you. Yay, these 4, they're amazing. So I think we're going to watch the little part of the film that these 4 people are in, and maybe you can watch the full film a little bit later, but we're just going to pull it up. So when people say to you, you're smart, what my undergrads, what my big students at Stanford said was, at first that feels good, but then later if you fail at something, you think, oh, maybe I'm not so smart. So that word is actually not a very good word, because everybody can grow their brains anytime. So let's hear from the wonderful 4th graders.
Hi, my name is Nava and I am 9 years old.
How would you feel if somebody told you that you were gifted?
I would feel great
How would you feel if your friends were told they were gifted, but you weren't?
Then I would kind of feel bad because they're telling all my other friends that they're gifted, but not me.
My name is Jude, and I am 10 years old.
Hi, Jude. When people say that somebody's smart, what do you think that means?
Well, if you say someone's smart, it's like, oh, they're smart and the other person is not.
What do you think about that?
I don't think that's very fair to label someone.
Like, either tell everybody, oh, you're a regular kid, or tell everybody you're gifted, because saying to one kid, oh, you're a gifted kid, no, you're not, can either drop their self-esteem or have it rise really fast.
If you're separating kids, one, they could work well together and they could collaborate, and two, if there's this group of kids who are supposedly not gifted, what if they can do something amazing and help the supposedly gifted kids?
I think if I grew up in a world where no one was labeled as gifted, I would have asked a lot more questions.
You can try as much as you want, and your brain will grow even if you get the answer fully wrong.
So how did it feel to know you can learn anything?
Great, because I had felt before that I could only learn like limited things, but now I kind of felt like I just wanted to grab a giant book and just read until I learned everything I could.
How do I feel knowing that I can learn anything?
Woo! Anything. Yes!
So how about a round of applause for our four students and that wonderful video, Marin, Minvir, Nava, Jude. And I want to thank you, Joe, for your wonderful presentation about telling us what we now know today about our brains and how all of us have the opportunity to learn and grow, and that it's super important to believe in ourselves and to be open to making mistakes. That's a great lesson. I also want to make sure we say hello to other friends from Stanford. We have Kathy Williams here and Monse Cordero, whom we've all met before. Let's give them a big round of applause. We are so thrilled to have this relationship with Stanford, working with Joe, Monse, and Kathy at Youcubed. And we're so glad that you're friends of PBS and that when you needed some actors and actresses, we were the go-to. That was great. We're glad to help anytime.